Y teacher.
Good evening. Can you hear me?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How's it going today? How are you today?
Fine, teacher.
Excellent. I'd like to hear that. I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. How about you, Ms. Alexander? How's it going today? Good, fine, more or less. More or less. So far, so good. So, so.
Today is Friday and the body knows.
Exactly, today is Friday and the body knows. Okay, good. All right. It is 7, it is 8 o'clock. So let's start the class. Good evening to everyone. Today we're going to go over, okay, we're going to refresh, we're going to recall a little bit about the previous topic. Vamos a estudiar un poco sobre los temas anteriores. Okay, we're going to have many, we're going to have practice. We're going to have a lot of practice, a lot of practice. Also, we're going to discuss in groups. Vamos a discutir en grupos. And we're going to see two important verbs. Vamos a ver dos verbos importantes. For example, need to and have to. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, but for to start, I brought two questions. Okay, I brought two questions. You ready? You ready to study this topic? For example, how many days a week do you rest? How many hours a day do you work? How much money do they pay for extra hour? Okay, and how much time do we have? How much time do we have? Okay, so we're going to discuss this question. Vamos a discutir estas preguntas. How many days a week do you rest? How many hours a day do you work? How much money do they pay for extra hour? And how much time do we have? Ok, vamos a discutir estas preguntas. Ok. Les voy a dar alrededor de 2 minutos para que piensen en, las respuestas. Y después las vamos a compartir. Ok, you have these 4 questions. You will have time to think about it. And then we're going to share the answers. Y vamos a pensar en las posibles respuestas de estas 4 preguntas.
Ridículo.
It is 4 questions.
Uy.
Okay, are you ready? Not yet? More time? Okay, more time. Okay, para los que van ingresando, ahorita vamos, tienen que pensar, okay, en estas 4 preguntas. Por ejemplo, how many days a week do you rest? How many hours a day do you work? How much money do they pay for extra hour? How much time do we have? Ahorita sus compañeros están pensando en las, están formulando las respuestas y después las vamos a compartir. Okay, let me know when you finish, please. Okay, let's start. Okay, question number one. How many days a week do you rest? Rest is descansar. How many days a week do you rest? Okay, how about Miss Brenda Lisette? How many days a week do you rest?
I rest one day a week.
Okay, what day it is?
One day.
Okay, is it Monday, Tuesday, Friday, Sunday, Saturday?
Sunday.
Sunday,
yes.
Do you work on Saturdays?
Yes.
Good. Okay. How about Miss Elsa? How many days a week do you rest?
One day.
Okay, one day.
Same Brenda, I work Saturday.
Saturday.
Saturday too.
Okay, good. Do you work all this Saturday or just in the morning?
Part-time.
Okay.
Only in the morning.
Okay, good. How about Miss Sunny? How many days a week do you rest?
I rest one day a week.
Okay.
It's on Sunday.
Sunday too. Okay, good. Excellent. ¿Alguien que descanse un día diferente? Does anybody rest another day?
Saturday, no, on Saturday.
Okay, you rest Saturday.
Saturday.
Okay, good. Okay, second question. How many hours a day do you work? How many hours a day do you work? About Mr. Alexander. Mr. Alexander, how many hours a day do you work? Your microphone, sir.
Sí, perdón, tenía dificultad con el micrófono. I work 8 hours a day.
Good, 8 hours a day. How about Mr. Juan Alberto? How many hours do you work a day, sir?
I work 5 days.
5 days.
Monday, yeah, to Friday.
And how many hours?
Friday, yes.
¿Cuántas horas por día?
I work 8 hours.
8 hours. Good. Excellent. Okay. How about Mr. Jose?
Hours, yes.
Jose Nicolas, how many hours do you work per day?
I work 8.
8?
8.
8 hours.
8 hours.
Good. Okay. Let me see. Overtime or OT. Tiempo extra. Okay. In case you work overtime, how much money do they pay for extra hour? Si no, lo vamos a inventar el la hora, okay? El costo. Okay. Let's begin with Miss Elsa. How much money do they pay for extra hour?
Inventado, ¿verdad? Porque a mí no me pagan horas.
Yeah.
Quiero ver. $12.
Okay, $12 per hour. Good. How about Miss Brenda? How much money do they pay per extra hour?
They pay $5.
$5, good. How about Mr. Carlos Martinez? How much money do they pay per extra hour?
$3.
$3, good. Excellent. Good job. Okay. All right. Okay. How much time do you use the computer? How about Ms. Carolina Eleonora? How much time do you use your computer? per day, por día, per day.
Six hours.
Okay, mm-hmm. Good. Esta pregunta la vamos a contestar así. I use the computer for 6 hours or five hours. Okay. Let's see. How about Mr. Jose Nicolas? How much time do you use your computer?
I work computer.
I use the computer.
I use computer eight hours. Eight hours.
Okay, good. How about Mr. Juan Alberto Rivas? How much time do you use your computer? In that case would be how much time, sorry. How much time do you use your computer? Okay, how about Mr. Edgar Jose? How much time do you use your computer?
Usually use the computer maybe 10 hours during
the 10 hours, that's a lot. Okay. All right, thank you very much. How about Ms. Maria Rivera? How much time do you check your Facebook? How much time do you check your Facebook? Okay. All right, thank you very much. Ok, ahora voy a tomar la asistencia, porque ya está la mayoría. Vamos a comenzar, hoy es el mes 30. Alexander Aro.
Present teacher.
Good. Brenda Lisset.
Present teacher.
Carla Lisset.
Present teacher.
Excelente. Carlos Alberto.
Present teacher.
Excelente. Carolina Eleonor Cardona de Alvarado.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Miss. Edgar Jose. Mr. Edgar Jose Cruz.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Elsa Merino de Villera.
Present teacher.
Good. Erickson René Díaz Mejía. Erickson René Díaz Mejía. Ever Giovanni Ortiz. Ever Giovanni Ortiz. Heidi Marisol Mengíbar Mengíbar. José Nicolás.
Present teacher.
Josué Alexander Flamenco Asensio. Josué Alexander. Juan Alberto Rivas.
Present teacher.
Excellent, sir. Juan José Cerón Quintanilla. Juan Ricardo Alvarenga Alas.
Present teacher.
Good. Kenia Rebeca Navarro Medrano.
Present teacher.
Good. Maritza Reyes López. Maritza Reyes López. Samuel Isidro Tejada Anaya.
Present.
Okay, Samuel Isidro Tejada Anaya.
Present teacher.
Good. Sonia Miriam Cortés Vargas.
Present teacher.
¿Qué más? Yes. Yesenia Emperatriz Escoto. María Magdalena Rivera Ruiz.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Miss. López Pérez. Okay, good. Okay, so in the previous class, you were creating your, for example, based in the paragraph. Okay, you were creating your own paragraph describing your activities that you usually do in the job. Okay, en la clase pasada nos quedamos en que ustedes estaban creando su propio párrafo. Okay, este párrafo. Okay, parecido a este párrafo, por ejemplo. Hello, my name is John Wilson. I work in an office. I am human resources manager. Every day I check email for the company. I always answer the phone and talk to potential employees. Generally, I attend meetings in the morning and not so often in the afternoon. In my company, we always have events. We have to attend a conference on July 21st, and then we have to attend meetings about the conference on July 22nd. I'm always busy, okay? ¿Qué dijimos que era busy? Que era busy, ocupado, okay? Por ejemplo, hoy que es fecha de pago, en ocasiones los bancos están muy ocupados. Entonces decimos, ah, the bank was very busy, was very crowded, muy lleno. Okay? O por ejemplo, esos días donde tiene que responder muchos correos, tiene que atender muchos clientes, entonces está muy ocupado. Entonces decimos en inglés, I'm very busy, busy, busy. Ok, se escribe busy, pero se pronuncia busy. Ok, busy. Ok, and sometimes, en ocasiones usted llama a Estados Unidos y le contesta a la recepcionista. Y usted muy amable le dice, hey, hello, how are you today? Entonces usted contesta que le diga, I'm fine, thank you. Pero no, en ocasiones solamente le dice, I'm busy. Ok, eso significa que quiere que le diga rápido, straight to the point, directo al punto. Okay, busy. So that is the word that we have today, busy. Okay. Vamos a continuar con la creación de su párrafo. Trate de incluir, por ejemplo, other frequency. Por ejemplo, always, often, never. Okay. Trate de escribir las cosas que usted hace en su trabajo. For example, if you check your email, se revisa su correo. Si llama a sus clientes, si... Ok, las actividades que comúnmente hace en su trabajo. The things that you commonly do in your job. Ok, so we're going to do that in trios. Okay. Vamos a trabajar en trios. And you will have 10 minutes to finish your paragraph. Va a tener 10 minutos para terminar su paragraph. Okay. There we go. In case you have any question, please let me know. Si tienes alguna pregunta, por favor.
Yo ya había avanzado en el párrafo. Entonces, aprovechando al teacher, lo voy a leer para que me diga si está correcto. Dice, hello, my name is Carolina de Alvarado. I work in an office. I am a secretary. Every day I make payments, I check emails for company, I check the WhatsApp, Facebook, Messenger for the company. I always make calls to parents. I attend the visit in the morning and not so often in the afternoon. In my company, attend public in days Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. I am always busy.
Good, busy. Muy bien.
Busy.
Muy bien. Ok, solo al inicio me puede repetir la primera frase. I work in something. ¿Podría repetir esa frase?
I work in an office.
Excelente, ahí estamos bien. Es que escuché que dijo, I work in is.
Ay, es que, ay, teacher, perdón, a mí siempre, no se los nervios me traicionan.
No, en realidad está aprendiendo bastante, se le nota.
Thank you, teacher. Thank you.
Se le ve más confiada a la hora de utilizar el idioma. O sea, confiada es que se ve como más confident. No sé cómo es. Confident
es así, como... sin miedo al éxito, exacto, teacher. Exacto. No importa si me equivoco, que me corrija el teacher.
Exacto. Esa es la forma, porque en ocasiones no aprendemos por el miedo a equivocarnos. Y todo conlleva errores.
Sí.
Entonces, bueno. Muy bien. Usted le felicita en la forma que usted está asumiendo.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, now voy a leer mi párrafo.
Good.
Hello, my name is Sonia Cortez. I work in Imprenta La Tarjeta. I am a quotation manager. Every day I check emails for the company. I always answer the phone and call to potential customers. I check the production order every day, and rarely I have a meeting.
Good. Very good. Okay, muy consistente en la gramática. Se le entiende bastante el mensaje. Muy bien, Misa.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, voy a ir a ver a los demás grupos.
Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
Hello.
Hola, teacher. Pregunta.
Tell me.
Logro escucharme bien.
¿Perdón?
Fíjese que como se le escuchó cortado, la indicación no le escuché bien.
Ah, sí, vi que ahí se quedó en la sala principal. Con gusto le vuelvo a explicar.
Sí.
Vaya, ¿se acuerda que de ayer estábamos escribiendo un párrafo?
Sí, el párrafo ya lo hice.
Ah, entonces ya avanzó bastante, porque sus compañeros están terminando en eso.
No, sí, eso ya lo hice yo.
Si gusta que lo escuche para... Tal vez le puede dar alguna corrección.
Va, se ve, le parece. Dice, hello, my name is Juan Rivas. I work in a high school. I am a teacher, science and letter. And every day I get class virtual. I always answer the phones and talk with my student. Which they had one question. Generally, attend a meeting of the class the days Monday and Thursday and Friday. Is something. Hey, only that.
Good. Bueno, y ahora lo va a volver a leer. Y le voy a ir corrigiendo las palabritas para que exista algún error.
Ok, teacher. ¿Otra vez?
Sí.
Hello, my name is Juan Rivas.
Bueno, ahí va a decir my name. Tiene que pronunciar la M.
Name.
Name. Good. Muy bien. My name.
My name is Juan Rivas.
Excelente.
Ok. I work. Okay. I work in high school.
Good.
I am a teacher.
Yeah, yes, I am a. Usted dice que es de ciencia, ¿verdad?
Sí, science.
I am a science teacher.
Science. I am a science teacher.
Good. I am science teacher. El adjetivo va antes.
Okay, science teacher. Science teacher, okay.
Science teacher and letter teacher.
And letter teacher. Thank you, teacher.
Letter. Puede decir, I am science and letter teacher.
Teacher, okay. I am a science and letter teacher.
Good.
Every day, I give class virtual.
Okay, ahí está, está en español. Entonces sería, every day I teach.
Every day I teach.
Ajá, good. Todos los días enseño.
Okay. Teach, sería teach class virtual.
Ajá, good. I teach virtual class, si puede también.
Virtual class, okay. Okay. Always and answer the phone and talk.
I always answer the phone.
I always
answer the phone.
I always answer the phone and talk.
And talk. Talk.
Okay. Talk. I always answer the phone and talk.
Good. Muy bien.
With my student.
Okay. With.
With.
Excellent. With. Ahí. Tiene que sacar la lengua. With.
With.
Excellent.
With my student.
Excellent.
Okay. Which day on a question?
Okay, esa parte no la entiendo.
Which they have on a question? No sé si cuando ellos tienen una pregunta.
Ok, eso sería when.
When.
Le voy a escribir aquí. When. They have a question.
Ok. When have a question. Ah, ok. When. When cuando have a question.
Ellos tienen una pregunta. When they have a question.
When they have a question. Ok. Generally, I attended meeting of class the days, Monday, Tuesdays, and Friday.
Okay. Friday. Good.
Friday. Okay.
Muy bien. Very good.
Thank you. Okay.
Muy bien. Se nota que está poniendo en práctica las reglas gramaticales. El simple present está muy consistente. Muy bien. También los adverb frequency también van bien situados, entonces está muy bien. Entonces, bueno. Ok, nada.
Bueno, gracias,
iré a otros grupos a chequear.
Bueno,
pero vamos a ver qué dice el teacher. Teacher, estamos platicando con Samu si vamos a tener vacación la otra semana.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Hi, teacher.
Así que va a poder ir con mucha paz al Mahahual.
No, el Mahahual. No, ya me diga ver Netflix, pero... No, no pienso salir.
Ok. Netflix in your home.
Yeah.
Good. How about Mr. Samuel? What do you have in mind? What are your plans?
Honestly, teacher, I don't have plans for the... vacations.
Oh,
because
okay.
I have to work all the
week. Sad.
Yes, it will be a little bit frustrated for me, but I think that is like I have to to stay to work, you know.
Okay, so you won't have 3 days.
No.
Okay.
Without vacations.
So sad.
Okay. Yes, a little bit.
No se vale, yo no la entiendo bien, hablan muy rápido.
Ok, ¿ya terminamos el párrafo?
Yo sí, teacher, le cuento a Samu que yo sí hice mi tarea, porque usted la dejó de tarea.
Good, ok, are you ready? La voy a escuchar. Yes.
Ah, eso sí me da pena. Bueno. Hello, my name is Elsa Merino. I work at a private university. I am academic administrator and teacher in the computer area. I usually coordinate the teaching and student activities of the classes. I check normally emails. I make reports for the institution and the coordinator. In also the coordination of events and rentals. I always supervise the internal activities of the Iron Man Company and the and its requirements.
Excellent.
All this with the collaboration of three people in the department. Más o menos.
Muy bien, oh, muy bien. Solo escuché que dijo I may report. Yes, I make report.
Ah,
okay. Puso el verbo en pasado. Yes, en presente. I make.
Ah,
okay. How about Mr. Samuel? Do you have it? Ready?
Yes, teacher.
Can I hear you?
Okay. I work in a company and I always go with products for my work. And also I often have to sell. Besides, I usually walk in my work into the neighborhood as well. I always make reports for my work.
Good. Excellent.
No, gerente de una constructora.
Ah, okay. Escuché.
Manager of a construction company.
Ah, okay. Excellent. Okay, interesante.
Okay.
Y usted trabaja, me dice, decía que trabajaba por proyectos, ¿verdad?
Sí, nosotros, bueno, en español, sí, hacemos proyectos.
Hello, finish.
Good.
Hasta ya lo practicamos.
Excellent.
Sí.
Okay, I want to hear you.
Okay. Hello, my name is Brenda. I work in an imprint. Generally, I attend a client. Also, I always answer the phone and talk to the client. Two, I hardly ever have meetings. And I check email and send email at my boss and client. After that, I always use the computer. Two, I make the payments to the client. And usually I write a report for my boss. Also, I normally check the social network, for example, Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp.
Good job, Miss. Muy bien. Muy bien su gramática. Los adverb frequency, muy bien colocado. También la pronunciación. Muy bien.
Thank you.
How about Miss Kenny?
Okay. Hello, my name is Kenya Navarro. I work in an office. I am in charge of legal process. Every day I check emails. I sometimes answer the phone and call important clients. Hardly ever I attend a meeting in the week. My company, I never have even. I am always busy.
Bien, okay, Miss Kenny. Okay, solamente vamos a corregir. Eventos, se dice events.
Okay.
Con una events.
Okay.
También I talked. Hablo con. I talk. Two important clients, creo que dijo. Que habla con.
Clients.
Que hable con. Entonces, talk to. I talk to important clients.
Ok. Debo agregar el to. I talk.
Okay, hello to everyone. Okay, now we're going to share your paragraph that you already wrote. Vamos a compartir. Okay, los párrafos que ya ustedes escribieron acerca o escribiendo las actividades que usualmente ustedes hacen en su trabajo. The things or the activities that you commonly do in your job. Okay, let's begin. Let me see. How about Mr. Edgar Jose Cruz?
Okay. Hello. My name is Edgar Cruz. I am a security dispatcher in the airport. So every day I check my computer and check my email for 10 hours. And also I work 12 hours. So every day and always I have to check in and check out for the visitors. And also we have to do and request an inspection for vehicles, or if one of the persons need to fill for the aircraft, we have to do the request and notify the people that is doing the inspection. So when I have a free time, for example, 1 hour, I go to the gym, but it's sometimes. And also, I have to send email and check the cameras. So I'm really busy in my work. And I just take a rest 2 days or 3 days a week.
Twice a week. Good. So you work a lot, sir. You are very busy. Okay, Ms. Elsa, tell me some things that Mr. Edgar usually does in his job. Some things that Mr. Edgar usually does.
Perdón, teacher, micrófono. He makes reports, check cameras, go to the gym.
Excellent, Ms. Elsa. Thank you very much. Okay, Mr. Edgar, choose one classmate, please.
Let me see. Ricardo Alvarenga.
Okay, Mr. Ricardo Alvarenga. Can you share with us your daily routine that you have in your job?
Okay. My name is Ricardo Alvarenga. Once I get my workplace, I turn on the computer and I open all the documents that I use, includes the my email, and then always we have to be alert, checking the cameras and all the time. And sometimes when we have free times, we can go to play soccer maybe, or go to the gym, or do, I don't know, any other kind of activity, just when we have free times. I have to work 12 hours per day, and I have to always be pending about the emails, because we have to make a daily list visitors.
Good. Thank you very much, Mr. Juan. Okay, okay. Ms. Brenda, tell me some things that Mr. Juan usually does in his job.
He usually check the cameras, and they can play soccer in your free time.
Yes, free time.
Free time, and always he invite the report.
He? Once again?
He?
You said she, and it's he. Once again, he?
He always implement the report.
Excellent. Good job. Okay, now, Mr. Ricardo, choose a volunteer. Well, choose a victim.
Okay, okay. Let me see. Juan Alberto.
Okay, Juan Alberto. He wants to be volunteer. Thank you, mister. There we go.
Okay. Hi, good evening, everybody. Hello, my name is Juan Rivas. I work in high school. I am a science and literature teacher. I teach class virtual. I always answer the phone and talk with my students when they had one question. Generally, I attend the meeting of class the days Monday, Tuesday, and Friday, and only that.
Thank you very much, Mr. Juan. Okay, how about Ms. Sonia? What is Mr. Juan's profession?
He is a teacher.
Okay, what subject? ¿Qué materia?
I can hear.
Okay. Mr. Juan Alberto, what is the subject that you teach?
I am teach science and letter.
Okay, science and letter.
Okay.
Good.
Science and letter.
Okay, let's see, let's continue. Okay, choose a volunteer, Ms. Juan. Mr. Juan Alberto.
Okay, is Tantacatán, Sonia Cortés. Sonia Cortés, lo siento, Sonia.
Okay,
no es nada personal.
No problem.
Okay, go ahead, Miss Sonia. Your microphone, please.
Sorry. Hello, my name is Sonia Cortez. I work in Imprenta La Tarjeta. I am a quotation manager. Every day I check emails, answer the phone, and call to potential customers. I must check the production order every day. I rarely have a meeting.
Thank you, Miss. Good job. Okay, how about Miss Carolina? Can you tell us what does Miss Sonia do in her job?
She call potential customer and manager.
She is manager
in Imprenta La Tarjeta.
Okay, and she works in
Imprenta La Tarjeta. Imprenta La Tarjeta.
Good. Okay, muy bien. Okay, solo le hizo falta agregar la S. Por ejemplo, she calls.
Okay. She calls.
Recordemos que cuando utilizamos he, she, it, en este caso estamos hablando de ella, entonces vamos a agregar la S o ES al verbo. She calls to potential clients. Okay, she sends emails or she checks the computer or the email. Good. Okay, Ms. Sonia, choose a volunteer, please.
Elsa Merino.
Okay, Ms. Elsa Merino.
Okay. Hello. My name is Elsa Merino. I work at a private university. I am academic administrator and teacher in the computer area. I usually coordinate the teaching and students. activities of the classes. I check normally emails, I make reports for the institution and for the MINED. In also the coordination of events and rentals. I always supervise the internal activities of the Ironman company and its requirements. All this with the collaboration of three people in the department.
Good, Ms. Elsa, thank you for your participation. Okay, choose a volunteer.
Samuel? Teacher Samuel.
Okay, Mr. Samuel.
Okay. Good night, everyone. I work in a company and I always go with products for my work. And also I often help to sell besides. I usually walk in my work into the neighborhood. As well, I always make reports for my work and I sometimes do bills for each product.
Thank you, Mr. Good job. Okay, choose someone, Mr. Samuel.
Alexander, I don't know.
Okay, Mr. Alexander, you are the chosen.
Hello, my name is Alexander Doño. I work in printing company. I am cartoonist in my work. I usually draw soccer books in box for packaging of different products. Sometimes I make photography drawings on wood. I also combine original seeds in copies for invoice blocks. Occasionally, I help my co-workers glue boxes and bags.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Alexander. Okay, choose someone, please.
Carolina.
Okay, Ms. Carolina.
Okay. Hello, my name is Carolina de Alvarado. I work in an office. I am a secretary. Every day I make payments. I check emails for company. I check the WhatsApp, Facebook, Messenger for the company. I always make calls to parents. I attend the visit in the morning and not so often in the afternoon. In my company, attend public in days Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. I am always busy.
Very good. Excellent, Miss. Very good. Excellent. Okay, choose someone. Be careful with the dog. Okay, choose someone. Elija alguien, Miss Caroline.
Carlos Martinez.
Okay, Mr. Carlos Martinez.
Okay. hi, my name is Carlos Martinez. I am a technician telecommunication. In a normal day, I solve internet, cable TV. Final. This from Monday to Friday.
That's it, right? Yeah, that's the end. Finish. Okay, good. To someone, Mr. Kat.
Ya quedan pocos. Carla Villalta.
Okay. Hello, my name is Carla Villalta. I am the manager of a construction company. I always supervise the workers of the different departments. And I am charge of going to meeting with the, our clients. I verify the paycheck of the worker and the work that each one performs. I am always busy in solving problems that are generated in the project. I am sharp supervises the work, verifying all the process. I have two babies and my days at night are very busy. And now with the classes, it is even busy. It's okay. All.
Good. Okay, busy. 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 Thank you, miss. Good job. Okay. I think Mr. Nicholas is missing. Mr. Nicholas, Jose Nicholas, are you ready? And then Miss Kenya Navarro.
Hello, teacher.
Are you ready? ¿Ya está listo?
Okay. Hello, my name is Nicolás García. I am the world the accounting control company. Where in the everything they have to do with a content in backpack and payment on usually every to the world and always living time for the partially time and speak at the club.
Okay. Good. Miss Kenya.
Okay. Hello, my name is Kenya Navarro. I am office. My profession is lawyer. I am in charge of legal process. Every day I check emails. I sometimes answer the phone and talk to important clients. Hardly ever I attend a meeting in the week. My company, I never have events. I am always busy. Finished.
Good. Okay, who's missing? Volunteer, algún voluntario? Only one.
Please.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Brenda.
Hello, my name is Brenda Garcia. I work in an imprint. Generally, I attend a client. Also, I always answer the phone and talk to clients. Then I hardly ever have meetings and check emails and send emails at my boss and clients. After that, I always use the computer to make the payments to the clients. And usually I write a report. Also, I normally check the social network, for example, Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp. And finish.
Good, excellent, good job. Okay, hasta el momento, muy bien la mayoría. Okay, muy consistente en la gramática, muy buena pronunciación y fluidez. Okay, y también estamos utilizando correctamente los adverb frequency, muy bien. También incorporan nuevo vocabulario, por ejemplo, busy, hardly ever, muy bien. Entonces, feedback, estamos muy bien. Felicidades a todos los que participaron. Estamos avanzando poco a poco, ¿ok? El aprendizaje del idioma es también el tiempo que usted le invierte y también es un proceso de paciencia. No crea que va a aprender de aquí en una semana va a estar hablando con fluidez. Todo es paso a paso y el tiempo que usted le invierte. Así que muy bien. Felicidades a todos. Okay. Lo han hecho muy bien. Excelente. Okay. Vamos a... solo pude captar algunas palabritas. Por ejemplo, esta. Por ejemplo, talk. Okay. Tenemos talk. Y únicamente la L queda... no pronunciamos la L. Va a sonar como una O y la K. Entonces se dice talk, ok? I talk, yo hablo con. Y para decir yo hablo con las personas, no es I talk with. Eso sería literalmente, sería, la forma correcta sería I talk to people. I talk to people, hablo con las personas. I talk to you, hablo contigo. I talk to, ok? La pronunciación sería talk. La L no se pronuncia. Talk. Okay. Talk to. También tenemos answer. Esta también, la pronunciación, no se pronuncia la W. Answer. Answer. Sería algo eso, la pronunciación. Answer. Answer. Ok, also... tenemos area, que decimos area, y la pronunciación es area. Area.
Pero eso es más que todo fonología.
Pronunciación. Area. Ok, también walk, que significa caminar. En esta no se pronuncia tampoco la L. Walk. 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 Tenemos talk, answer, area, and walk. Okay, Mr. Juan.
Yes.
Tell me the first word, please. Dígame esta palabra.
Talk.
Excellent. Mr. Alexander, this, please. The second one.
Answer.
Excellent. Good job. Answer. Muy bien. Miss Brenda?
Area.
Area. Good. Excellent. And Miss Sonia? Walk. Excellent. Muy bien. Walk. Very good. Okay. Ya tuvimos. Muy bien. Okay. And now we're going to practice the topic that we studied yesterday. Vamos a revisar un poco el tema que vimos el día de ayer, que fue los imperatives. Los imperatives. Ok, voy a compartir en el chat. Ok, el link. Si alguien me puede hacer el favor para colocarlo en el grupo de WhatsApp, ahorita disculpe. O sea, puede ingresar desde acá. El link está en el chat.
O sea que quiere, pero como ni más, pero para mí quiera de pan.
Gracias, Carolina. Mr. Nicolás. Ok, el link ya está en el WhatsApp y también puede ingresar desde el chat de Zoom. Okay, so we have Carolina, Miss Carla, Miss Brenda, Miss Carlos, Mr. Erickson. We have Mr. Juan Rivas, Miss Elsa, Mr. Samuel. Thank you. Well, here, can we start?
Yes.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, action. Okay, let's see the winner. Okay, the top five. Okay, top five, Mr. Erickson, Mr. Edgar, Ms. Elsa, second place, Mr. Samuel, and Ms. Brenda. Okay, she is the winner, Ms. Brenda. Congratulations. Good job, Ms. Okay, excellent. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hold on. Voy a compartir con ustedes otro link, solo denme un minuto que está cargando.
Le duelen los pies, dice la Paola, y tiene hambre, quiere comer, mejor se va a venir.
Bueno, no, no pude cargar esto. Ok, well, let's continue. Vamos a continuar con el uso de have to and need to. Okay, let me know if you can see the presentation, please. Okay, so you will express obligation or needs at the workplace. Okay, let's start. Okay, what are some of your obligations at your workplace? Una de sus obligaciones en el lugar de su trabajo. Vamos a utilizar el verbo need, okay, need, que significa necesito, o have, que significa tengo que, have to. Por ejemplo, traje, dice, I have to be on time. Yo debo de estar a tiempo. I have to be on time. También tengo el verbo need, que significa necesitar, y dice, I need to be on time. Okay. Also, I have to achieve a goal. Debo de alcanzar una meta. Okay. Available, okay, make reports about the withholding voucher stealing. Okay. Vamos a utilizar el verbo need, que significa necesito, y el verbo have, significa yo tengo que, I have to. Y vamos a escribir ciertas cosas que usted tiene que hacer en su lugar de trabajo. Por ejemplo, utilizando have to or need to. Have to, que significa tengo que, y need to, que significa necesito. Need to. Por ejemplo, usted puede decir, I have to send email to the client. Debo de enviar correos a los clientes. I have to. Algunas obligaciones que usted tiene en el lugar de su trabajo. Ok, vamos a escribir únicamente así. Okay, utilizando have to or need to. Debo de o necesito.
Teacher, perdón.
Yes.
¿Cuántas oraciones?
5, mis hijas.
Ok, gracias. Thank you.
Okay, describiendo sus obligaciones en su trabajo, utilizando el verbo have to o need to.
Ok. Thank you.
Okay, finished. Ok, ahora que usted ya creó sus oraciones, las vamos a compartir con los compañeros.
Yo tengo que hacer, poner todos los días el café, pero no sé, I have to. ¿Cómo ponerlo? No sé cómo.
Sí, tiene que contestar llamadas, digamos, si en el trabajo tiene que hacer eso. I have to answer calling. Pero, ¿de qué se trata?
¿Hola?
¿De qué se trata?
Vaya, como él dijo, las obligaciones. Vaya, una primera, nosotros en eso tenemos la obligación de poner el café todos los días.
Ajá.
Vaya,
entonces, esa sería una.
Ajá, I put the coffee. Where I have to put the coffee.
I have to.
Put. P-U-T. Put. The coffee.
Y estará bien redactada. I have a report every day.
Perdón, ¿podría repetir? No la escucho muy bien.
I have a report every day.
Yeah, I have to report every day. Muy bien.
I had to clean en teléfono.
Tiene que, perdón, ahí qué es.
Tengo que llamar a los clientes.
Ah, entonces I have to call the client.
¿Qué significa need?
Necesito.
Y para decir I have emito cheques.
Necesita enviar, ¿cómo era? Enviar o recibir, ¿cómo fue?
No, emitir cheque.
Vamos a buscar un sinónimo de emitir, por ejemplo, enviar, ¿verdad? O crear.
Crear, hacerlo.
Ok, I have to do checks.
Teacher, in my case, I need to consult price for make quotation. It's correct.
Yeah, it's correct.
Faltaba una, Marita. Sí, pero en la, este, ¿cómo se llama? I had, para llegar a acabarla, la, como decir, puntual, ¿cómo me dijo?
I have to be on time.
Lo último no lo entiendo.
Ok, se lo escribo.
Ajá. Sería I have to on time.
Aquí se lo voy a escribir completo. I have to be on time. Okay. Esa es una de sus obligaciones, imagino. Debe estar a tiempo. I have to be on time.
Las leo.
Okay.
I have to be on time.
Okay. Time.
I have to coffee.
I have to put the coffee.
I hand a report every day.
Excellent. I have to. Tiene que enviar un reporte, ¿verdad?
Sí. I have to call to client.
Okay. I have to call the client.
I have to call to cloud.
Client.
Client.
Client. Muy bien.
I have to check.
Check the reports.
Finish.
Ok, muy bien, Miss Maritza. Muy bien.
Thank
Teacher, teacher, I have a question. Hello, Ricardo. Teacher.
Hello.
Hello, teacher. I have a question.
Come.
And the case when the example donde dice make a report about the with Eileen about this styling, también tenemos que hacer un ejemplo con ese tipo de oración.
Sí, utilizando have to.
Have to. Ah, ok. Yo pensaba que era solamente una.
Cinco oraciones.
Ajá. Otra pregunta, cuando decimos caja chica, ¿es box smile o petty cash? ¿Ves que caja chica de dinero?
Ok, dame un minuto y se lo escribo en el chat.
Porfa.
Ok, who wants to start?
Teacher.
Okay, let's start with Miss Sunny. Thank you.
Thank you. I have to be on time in my job. Okay. I have to answer callings.
Good.
I have to check the production order every day. I need to consult price for make quotations.
Excellent.
I have to send quotation on time.
Muy bien. Okay, very good. How about Mr. Alexander?
I have to arrive early in my job.
Okay, you have to arrive early at your job.
I have to combine our original sheet and copies for invoice blocks.
In where, sorry? Alone?
For invoice blocks.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Mr. Alexander. How about Ms. Brenda?
I have to attend the client.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to check my email.
Excellent.
And I need to sell a lot. And I need to talk the clients.
Excellent.
And finally, I have to answer the phone.
Okay, good. How about Mr. Jose Nicolas?
I have to the in the content. I need to be Eva y Pago Cuenta. I need it to be in the computer, in the meter, and meter. Finish the show.
Excellent. Okay, how about Miss Elsa?
I need a new computer. I have to make report for the Friday. I have to talk with my boss. I need to remote process. I need to change my schedule. I finished, teacher.
Good. Excellent. Okay, let me see, how about Miss Carolina?
Yes, I have to make payments. I have to answer calls. I have to academic record. I need to be daily income report.
Good, excellent. Okay, is there any volunteer? Voluntario?
Me, teacher.
Thank you, Mr. Juan.
I have to on time for my class. I need to more internet. I have to check a homework. She has to check a pretty cash.
Okay.
She need to get early to work. She need to use the computer.
Excellent.
Thank you.
All right, let me see. Okay, well, now let's continue with okay, and here you have some example using need. Okay, for example, it says, I really need that memo, right? Okay, es como que lo necesita mucho. I really need that memo. Okay, está en la página 25. Okay, también está, I need to speak to Mr. Wilson, please. It is very important. Necesito, ¿ok? Necesito hablar. Aquí también puedo, como les decía, puedo utilizar esta frase que significa es que lo necesita mucho. I really need that memo. I really need that number. I really need your email. Something like that. ¿Ok? También tenemos una pequeña lectura utilizando need to and have. From Dear Guadalupe. These are some of the tasks for this month. Okay, tasks son como cosas que debe de hacer, como obligaciones. Task. Okay, I really need you to contact with the first three potential customers in the list from Mr. Sanchez. You have 3 days to do it. 3 hours each day. Call the new clients from the last 3 weeks and give them the catalog information for John. Okay, you have 2 days to do it. 1 hour each day. It is very important to send the 2 latest sales report on May 26th. And then write a new welcome letter for the new customer. You have 1 day to do it. 4 hours. Finally, visit the 2 stores in Santa Tecla. You have 2 days to do it. 2 hours each day. Organize your week. Thank you. Best regard. Okay, como pueden darse cuenta, aquí se utiliza mucho el have, que significa tú tienes que. Okay, por ejemplo, cuando su jefe le envía o nuestro jefe nos envían correos, nos dice, hey, I need you to do this. Necesito que haga esto. Y si es con mucha urgencia, hey, I really need you to send me this email. Okay. Entonces tenemos esta pequeña conversación. Vamos a practicar la pronunciación de esta lectura y lo vamos a hacer de una forma grupal. Okay. Vamos a hacer en parejas. Okay. You have 2 minutes.
va a ser ¿sí?
Mark. Bueno, lo puede, ser Mark? Podemos hacer Mark.
¿O cómo?
Sí, en lo que yo busco mi.
Vale, yo soy Mark y usted Brisa. ¿Sí?
Me, Brie.
I really need that memo.
Just a moment, please.
You need to speak to Mr. Wilson, please. It's very important.
Right away.
Please.
Ahora con Carlos.
Okay. Yo solo tengo parte de la conversación.
Solo son cuatro oraciones.
Ah, pues de las cuatro solo tengo tres. Dos son de B, de Bree.
Bree. Y entonces empieza Mark.
Vaya, entonces que inicie alguien como Mark y yo voy como Bree.
Voy a hacer Mark ahora yo.
Ok.
I really need that memo, Bree.
Just a moment, please.
I need to speak to Mr. Wilson, please. It's very important.
Right away.
Okay.
Ahí está. Ahora podemos practicar.
Catalogue. Information for you. You have 2 days to do it. 1 hour each day. It's very important to send to lesson short reports on May 26th. In the right and need welcome leader for the new customer. You have 1 day to do it for hours. Finally, visit the store in Santa Tecla. You have 2 days to do it. 2 hours each day. Organize your week. Thank you. Best regard. Ay, hice lo mejor que pude. Está complicado.
Bien, está bien. Así es como se aprende.
Okay. Oh,
seguimos. Sí.
Continúa.
¿Ya finalizaron?
Sí.
Ya pasamos.
Okay. La última vez y finalizamos.
Okay. Dear Guadalupe, these are some of the tasks for this month. I really need you to contact the first 3 potential customers in the list from Mr. Sanchez. You have 3 days to do it, 3 hours each day. Call the new clients from the last 3 weeks and give them the catalog information for June. You have 2 days to do it, 1 hour each day. It's very important to send the 2 latest sales reports on May 26th and the write a new welcome letter for the new customer. You have 1 day to do it, 4 hours. Finally, visit the 2 store in Santa Tecla. You have 2 days to do it. 2 hours each day. Organize your week. Thank you, your best regard.
Muy bien. Muy bien. Solo es catalog. Catalog.
¿Cómo?
Catalog.
Catalog.
Ajá, catalog.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, let's start. Okay, how about Miss Elsa? Tell me to read. When I say stop, then I'm going to, well, another classmate will continue. When I say stop, otro compañero continúa. You ready, Miss Elsa?
Yes.
Okay, there you go.
Dear Guadalupe, these are some of the tasks for this month. I really need you contact the first the potential customer in the list from Mr. Sanchez. You have 3 days to do it, 3 hours each day.
Okay, stop there. Thank you. Continue, Miss Brenda.
Sorry, teacher, me perdí donde iba.
Call the new.
Okay. Call the new clients from the last 3 weeks. And give them the catalog information for June. You have 2 days to do it, 1 hour each day. It's very important to send the to do. Okay.
Thank you, Miss Sunny.
Okay. It's very important to send the 2 latest sales reports on May 26th and to write a new welcome letter for the new customers. You have 1 day to do it, 4 hours. Finally, visit the 2 stores in Santa Tecla. You have 2 days to do it, 2 hours each day.
Okay, organize your week. Thank you very much. Okay. All right, ahora vamos a discutir las 4 cosas que tiene que hacer. Número 1. Okay, what does Guadalupe have to do?
Need your contact. She really need contact freeze potential customer, Mr. Sancher.
Okay, como estamos utilizando, como estamos... Okay, perdón. Como estamos contestando, estamos utilizando la tercera persona que es Guadalupe y Guadalupe es she. Vamos a agregarle eso a los verbos. Por ejemplo, se dice, has 3 days to do it. Por ejemplo, she has 3 days to do it. Recuerden que cuando utilizamos he, she, it, el verbo have cambia a has. Estamos need, vamos a decir he needs to. Okay, the first thing that she has to do, it is, Miss Carolina, you were saying?
Call the new
clients. What? Can you say it again? She has to.
She needs to call the client.
Okay. Muy, very good. She needs to call the client. Once again, please.
She give the catalog information for June.
Okay, good. And third?
Mm.
¿Cuál es la tercera obligación de Miss Guadalupe?
She sent the two light salary report on May 26.
Okay, y la última, the fourth.
And finally, she visits to the two store in Santa Tecla.
Okay, she has to visit.
She has to visit.
Uh-huh. Muy bien.
Two stores.
Muy bien.
Two stores.
Okay,
good. Tú lo sabes.
Yes. Now it's time to study. Okay, let's have the conversation. Okay, let's see. Miss Brenda, she will be John, and Miss Kenya, she will be Anne. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, let's start.
Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes. Okay. Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule meeting for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Reschedule.
Reschedule.
Eso es como reprogramar. Reschedule.
Reschedule. 2 minutes for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, that. Too bad.
Yes, I had to provide important information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
Interesting.
No sé cómo.
Interesting.
Interesting.
Okay.
Okay. How about? Let me see. Miss Sonia and Mr. Alexander. Mr. Alexander will be John, and Miss Sonia will be Anne.
Okay. Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to rush to the two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customer.
That sounds interesting.
Okay, very good. Okay, that sounds interesting.
Interesting.
Okay. Interesting. Okay, so we have reschedule. Reschedule is reagendar.
Reschedule.
Reschedule. Viene de la palabra schedule. Schedule, que es como calendario. Como programar, reprogramar. I have to reschedule 2 meetings for tomorrow. Okay, and information. Let me see. And that sounds interesting. Okay, ya realizamos actividad donde ustedes usaron have to and need to. Right? For example, Jose and Nicolás, tell me. One thing that you have to do in your job. Una cosa que tenga que hacer en su trabajo. Debe de.
We have to.
I have to.
I have to.
Sorry, you have to what?
I have to contact the was. I have to contact.
Good. How about Ms. Kenya Navarro? Tell me a thing that you have to do in your job, or that you need to do in your job.
Okay. I need to use the computer.
Okay. The computer. Good.
Okay. I have to check. Pericast.
Okay. Good job. Very good. Okay. Vamos a tener la última actividad. Okay. Vamos a escribir. Vamos a escribir cosas que usted debe de hacer o necesita hacer durante esos días en su trabajo. Pero en esta ocasión vamos a escribir cuándo, a qué horas y en qué lugar. Vamos a escribir cosas que usted debe de hacer o necesita hacer en su trabajo utilizando cuándo, a qué horas y dónde. Ok, al menos cinco. Usted elige cómo las ordena, pero tiene que ir al menos una de cuándo, a qué horas y dónde. Esta actividad la puede encontrar en la página 27. Ok, y la vamos a trabajar en pareja.
De class.
Okay. Entonces son preguntas, ¿cómo se llama? Referente a las actividades que realizamos.
Sí. Sí.
Okay. Bueno.
Pero entiendo que a la misma pregunta, o sea, a la misma actividad, perdón, le vamos a dar la respuesta de cuándo lo hacemos, ¿a qué horas lo hacemos? ¿En dónde lo hacemos? ¿Verdad? ¿O estoy equivocada?
Okay, yo creo que sí. No, o sea, no estoy equivocada. Eso es lo que vamos a hacer.
Brenda.
Ok, si quiere lo hacemos, Brenda, individual y luego lo
La segunda puse hablar con mi jefe.
hablar con mi jefe. Entonces sería when. La mía es I have to answer callings.
Answer
callings. Llamadas.
Ah.
I have to answer callings. When? Voy a poner Monday. What time?
Como digo, a regresar de vacación.
I come back from vacation. Come back from vacation.
Okay. Come back.
Vacation. Okay. En las horas, teacher, se puede usar el half past como para half media hora.
Yeah, half past eight. 30 pasadas las 8.
Half past eight. Where? In my job. In my office.
La tercera, pues.
Don't fall asleep, Juan.
I really, I wear things. I think the sentences.
Okay, good.
Yes.
Bueno, que vienen las vacaciones, mister.
My vacation is starting in day Sunday.
Sunday? Ah. Do you have classes tomorrow?
Tomorrow I go to the work. I release and want a course of the
five.
The education of the test avanzo.
Ah, okay.
Yes. And I arise in the world at the 7 in the morning o'clock. I start in the class of the reinforced.
Good. Okay, Miss Maritza. A usted le toca ahora el one by one. No, 10 minutos de explicación individual. Entonces, okay. Mantenga la lista, usted se queda.
Bye.
Okay, we are back. Estamos de nuevo. Bueno, vamos a dejar esto para cuando regresemos de vacaciones. Okay, vamos a tomar asistencia. Recuerda, la siguiente semana es vacaciones, por ende no vamos a tener clase. Sino que regresamos hasta el siguiente lunes, no me equivoco.
Oh, yes.
Regresamos lunes 9 de agosto.
Excellent.
Okay. Así que voy a tomar la asistencia.
No.
Okay, and Mr. Alexander Aaron.
Present, teacher.
García Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Amaya Castro.
Present, teacher.
Segura Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Cardona de Alvarado.
Present, teacher.
Cruz Amaya.
Sure.
Elsa Merino.
Present teacher.
Díaz Mejía. Díaz Mejía. Ever Giovanni. Ever Giovanni. Heidi Marisol. José Nicolás.
Present teacher.
Josué
present
Alexander. Teacher. Josué Alexander. Juan Alberto.
Present teacher.
Juan José Cerón. Juan Ricardo Alvarenga Alas.
Present teacher.
Kenia Rebeca.
Present teacher.
Maritza Reyes. Samuel Isidro.
Present teacher.
Sonia Miriam.
Present teacher.
Yesenia Emperatriz. María Magdalena Rivera Ruiz.
Present teacher.
Good, excellent. Ok. Espero que tengan una excelente vacación. Okay, you may have a blessed vacation. Así que I wish you all the best. If you drink, don't drive. And if you drive, don't drink. Have a good one. See you next Monday. Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.
Good night.
Thank you, Miss Carolina.
Bye. Thank you to all of you.
Bye.
Thank you. Ok, Miss Maritz, estos 10 minutos que tenemos, bueno, 9, son para que si usted tiene alguna duda sobre algún tema, no importa, cualquier tema, puede ser el primer tema de la primera clase o la pronunciación de alguna palabra, con mucho gusto le voy a explicar. Entonces, no sé qué tema le gustaría repasar.
Del don y dasen.
Con gusto. Muy bien. Solo le voy a compartir el... Voy a proyectar la presentación. Vaya, aquí tenemos, vamos a hacer un repaso del simple present, porque es donde contiene el doesn't y el don't. Vaya, como usted se recuerda, a la hora de hablar inglés, siempre utilizamos los pronombres. Los pronombres son, por ejemplo, cuando decimos yo, él, ella, nosotros, it, que es neutral para cosas o animales, y... para decir, por ejemplo, yo voy a la playa. Entonces, ese es el presente simple. ¿Okay? Tiempo gramatical en el presente. Y decimos, I go to the beach. I go to the beach, right? Para decir, yo voy a la playa. I go to the beach. En este caso dice, I
go
like.
To the beach.
Ajá, aquí dice, I like cheese. ¿Verdad? Que significa, sí. Me gusta el queso, por ejemplo. Uh-huh. Entonces, para hacer la forma negativa, para decir... A mí no me gusta el queso. O yo no voy a la playa. O yo no manejo el automóvil. Utilizamos don't.
Don't.
Más el verbo. Pero únicamente vamos a utilizar don't con I, we, you, or they. Únicamente con esos cuatro.
Uh-huh.
Cuando utilizamos he, she, it, en ese caso... Vamos a utilizar doesn't más el verbo. En este caso es like, que significa gustar. Entonces, en resumen, únicamente vamos a utilizar don't con I, we, you, they. Y vamos a utilizar doesn't únicamente con he, she. Sí, es. No sé si tiene otra pregunta.
De este, no.
De este, no.
Queda claro.
Ok.
Quiero ver. De lo que estaban viendo ayer, creo que de lo que les dejo la tarea, que íbamos a utilizar los adverbios, creo que era lo que estaban viendo el tema de ayer.
Los adverbios de frecuencia, dice usted.
Ajá. Yes.
Por ejemplo, cuando utilizamos usually, sometimes, ¿es ese tema?
No. Lo último, pero no recuerdo, adverbios de tiempo, no.
Se lo voy a mostrar y usted me dice si es ese.
Va.
¿Es este?
No.
Ok, vamos a ver si es los imperativos.
Ah, y eso, los imperativos.
¿Lo puede ver?
Sí.
Vaya, los imperativos mis son, por ejemplo, cuando nosotros damos órdenes o sugerencias. En este caso, no utilizamos, sujetos al inicio o pronombres. Por ejemplo, cuando usted le dice a su hijo, ¿verdad? Usted le dice, abre la puerta. Y le estamos dando una orden, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Okay. Entonces dice, open the door. O cuando el niño va al colegio y lleva los zapatos sucios, entonces usted le sugiere, ¿verdad? De una forma tranquila, le dice, clean your shoes. Clean your shoes. Ok. O si le dice a alguien, siéntese, por favor. Sit down, please. Sit down, please. Entonces, esas frases son, o esos verbos, son llamados imperativos, porque los utilizamos para dar una orden o una sugerencia. ¿Ok? Pero, cuando usamos los imperativos y utilizamos esta palabra que está acá abajo, que dice let's, no sé si la logra ver.
Sí.
Ok, let's es como, es una forma de imperativo donde usted está incluida. Entonces se incluye en la acción. Por ejemplo, dice, let's run. Porque si la traduciéramos, dijera, vamos a correr. Let's run. Usted se está incluyendo en la acción. ¿Okay? En la de arriba, usted no se incluye, únicamente le dice a la otra persona. Pero en la de abajo, donde dice, let's, usted se incluye. Usted hace parte de la actividad. O si usted le dice, vamos a la playa, let's go to the beach. Si está con su familia y le dice, vamos a ir al parque, vamos al parque. Let's go to the park. También tenemos, let's take a picture. Let's take a picture. Ok, y tenemos más ejemplos de los imperativos. Por ejemplo, look at the bird. Look at the bird. Point to everywhere. Point to everywhere. Pick up the trash. Recoge la basura. Pick up the trash. Clean those windows. Clean those windows. Put on your jacket. Put on your jacket. Cuando el clima está muy frío, se le dice a su hijo, ponete el suéter, ponte la chaqueta. Put on your jacket. Okay, stay close to the house. Listen to the teacher. Listen to your classmate. Let's dance. Let's dance. Por ejemplo, usted le dice a su esposo, vamos a bailar. Entonces usted está incluida en esa acción.
Let's dance.
Let's dance. Let's dance. Digamos, usted quiere comer algo y le dice a su compañera de trabajo, vamos a comer. Let's eat.
Let's eat.
Let's close the window. Ok, y esos son los imperativos. No sé si tiene otra pregunta. ¿No?
Solamente. Sí, solamente.
Ok, Miss Marita. Hasta el momento siento que se está involucrando bastante en la clase, así que le felicito. Le animo también a que siga practicando y participando durante la clase, porque es la única forma en la que podemos mejorar, ¿verdad?
Sí, solo que en algunas ocasiones sí no le entiendo realmente que los pregunta o a veces cuando me preguntan desconozco algunas palabras y ahí siento que me pierdo bastante.
Ok, entonces usted no
tiene pena. Eso me puede dar para como para conocer más.
Ok, lo que le sugiero es que no digamos, si usted no entiende alguna de las indicaciones, no tenga pena y me puede escribir, mire, no le entendí la última parte. Si usted tiene pena de hablar en frente de su compañero, usted me puede escribir el chat, me podría repetir la última indicación, yo con mucho gusto se la vuelvo a aclarar. O si usted se siente con la confianza de decirme durante la clase, activar su micrófono, mire, no entiendo tal indicación o qué tengo que hacer, yo con mucho gusto le vuelvo a repetir porque yo sé que estamos aprendiendo y es uno de los primeros niveles.
Sí. Vale, muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias a usted, Miss Maritza, y como le repito, le animo a que siga practicando y participando durante las clases.
Bueno, gracias.
Ok, no. Good night. And see you next Monday. La veo el siguiente lunes. Bye bye.
Bye.